question before you now is, why invest in Sri Lanka? What is so special about Sri Lanka that should attract you to make investments in this country? Unlike in the past, Mangal and I have addressed many meetings, many investment fora, but today we are living in a different world when investment must take a different meaning in the context of sweeping economic and global changes in this world. Many of the assumptions that we had regarding growth, regarding the future of investments, is undergoing a change. During the last few years, many of our projections, our prognostications regarding the global economy, regarding the economies of our region, have been scaled down. So in that context of a rapidly changing scenario, what makes Sri Lanka so attractive, even though we are well aware of the fact that we are not the only girl on the beach? So what is so special about Sri Lanka? I think the first is that we are a democratic country. We are a country which has regular elections, and not only elections, but regular changes of governments and administration. This is not a claim that can be easily made by many of our competitive, attractive countries. So this is a very important matter that has to be recognized. And just now, we have a government which is a coalition government, a coming together of the two major parties in the country, which gives a degree of stability and a certain degree of a guarantee about the assurances that are given by this government. So one is the democratic history of this country and the constitutional guarantees that have been granted to foreign investors. Number two, I think, is the quality of our people. Sri Lanka, for the last 70 years, even before we achieved independence, invested money in free education, free health, welfare in our rural areas, in social welfare measures and so on, so that today we have a very literate population with gender equality. This is the only country in this region which has absolute gender equality, not only in education and also higher education, but in an increasing trend of employment. So we have a democratic country with a large investment in education and social welfare, which creates a population which is amenable to change, which is able to make use of technological and other transformations that are going on. Then number three, I recall recently when we had very distinguished economists. We had George Soros, we had Bob Hausmann, we had many other distinguished economists here to talk about the Sri Lankan economy. And they all, in lighter vein, said, how did you manage to choose your neighbors? Because we are very lucky with our neighbors. We are right in the center. On one side there is the Middle East, on the other hand the growing countries of the Far East. We are just 20 kilometers away from the huge market and growing market of India with its middle class, and also China, with whom we have excellent relations. One can't imagine a better geographical position when it comes to investment and creating a hub in the region. Then look at the other political and social activities and problems that are visible in the world. The Middle East, which was just a few decades ago, the fastest growing region in the world, with huge assets and stability, has today unfortunately become an unstable area. They were the best of friends for Sri Lanka. For example, our tea industry depended very largely on the buyers from the Middle East. Many of our people, particularly our women, found employment in the Middle East.